Hey folks, a lot of you see us do these videos about European mounts, how to boil your skulls, and the reason we do it is with all the new rules related to chronic wasting disease and the inter or sometimes even intra-state transfer of places of skulls and brain tissue and spinal tissue from places that have CWD to other states or other areas. Those rules are complicating life. So if you like Euro mounts like I do, got a whole shop of them here, you shoot a young bull like this in Montana like I did 2 days ago, and you want to do a Euro mount. So I'm going to show you something that I just stumbled across that makes this really, really slick, called the Bridger Boiler. I've always had this problem of these little burners, big buckets. How do you balance it? How do you transport it? You got to do all this out in the field. Well, Bridger Boiler must have been reading my mail, must have been listening to me and my frustrations, because they have come out with the ticket. You'll see one of the things that you do before you get started on a Euro mount, you want to get the head trimmed up as much as you possibly can. The ivories right there where my finger is. And I already popped those out. So he's ready to be dropped in the water, get a little borax or a little Dawn liquid dish soap, and that'll grab all the oil as it comes off, and you're ready to go. Everything comes in this really compact little kit. It even comes with a refillable propane tank. If you're like me and you've got multiple of those 20 pound barbecue tanks laying around, you can grab one of those. The hose and the adapter all fits, works on the same thing. So in states where you're not allowed to bring an animal across state lines, which anymore just about every state, you throw this little Bridger Boiler kit in your truck and you're set. It doesn't take up much space. You can boil all of the brain and tissue cavity out of there, bring it home. If you want to do it at home, you can do all the whitening and you're set. One of the cool things about this Bridger Boiler is it comes with these eye bolts that can be adjusted up or down or back and forth along the rail on the edge of the boiling pot. And that allows you to keep the head as level as possible, both in terms of how far the nose is forward or up, and like this. And that is key to keeping the water, the hot water, from getting on parts of the antler, which are going to cause your antler to fade and change color. Now I'm just going to light it, put a little bit of Dawn dish soap in there, put the lid on it, let it simmer, come out and check it every hour or so. Use a little bit of a scraper or knife, a brass brush really works good when the debris starts coming off. And it won't be long and this thing will be done. It's taken a little while, but I boiled everything, scraped everything off it, and took it over, washed it all off. And now I'm getting ready to do the whitener. One thing that the Bridger Boiler sends you is you see these brushes and this pick right here. These picks are good if you got cracks and little places where you still got some tissue in there, you can go pluck it out of there. This peroxide is some pretty potent stuff, so I always wear gloves when you're using it. So this little container they send you, I'm gonna put the whitener and the peroxide in here, mix it up, use the brush, and we'll be whitened up in no time. Get in every little nook and cranny. At first, I'm going to do the outside, just the obvious places. And then I'm going to do all of the places inside the nasal cavity, inside the eyes. There's just a ton of places that you need to cover, and put it on liberally. Don't skimp on it, because if you skimp on it, you're going to end up with some places that are more yellow looking and some that are very white looking. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this grocery bag right here, put it over the skull. You just want to make sure that this is sealed so that the peroxide has a chance to do its work and whiten everything up. And I'll lay this over where there's a window, and I know the sun's gonna hit it and heat it up. If you wanna take it inside your shop at, or your heated shop or heated garage, go ahead and do that. It'll make it work even faster. And in a day or so, I'll come open this up, see how it worked.
Well, it's been a couple days. I've been busy, so I let this head sit out here. Try to get it whitened up as much as possible. It's right down here in this bag. So we're gonna open it up, see what it looks like. I think it should be good to go.
So there you go. Right now you'll see there's a lot of extra stuff on it. If you wanna get that stuff off, just get a soft brush and rub it on there. Those last pieces will come off and you're ready to go.
So there you have it, right? Pretty easy. One, shoot an elk. Two, trim all the hide and every bit of loose tissue off it. Three, boil it to get it right down to the bone. Four, whiten it, and you're all done. That simple. Thanks for watching.